Hi, my name's Cole Gertis, and this video is about
Troubleshoot a Sprinkler Zone.
A step-by-step walkthrough for diagnosing a water valve zone that is not working. For this video, I made a handy-dandy cheat sheet printout so that you can do all the steps without having your phone out. Because by golly, your sprinkler system will work again today, and there's nothing worse than having a working sprinkler and a wet, broken phone. The link is down below. Please let me know how it works out for you. Sprinkler valves are relatively simple. There's a timer that sends electricity to a solenoid, and the solenoid opens up a diaphragm to let water pass through. There's a couple extra parts, but that's kind of the gist of it. Okay, step one for diagnosing a water zone that's not working is to make sure that the power is going to your timer and that the main valve is on for your water supply. I know, I get it, trust me. It's kinda like yelling, "Hey, did you check your pants pockets?" when you're looking for your keys.
Of course I did, it's the first place I looked.
But without that piece, none of the rest of it's gonna work. Step two is to see if the non-functioning valve will operate manually when you open the bleed screw. Some of them can also be opened by turning the solenoid 1/4 turn. If the sprinkler doesn't turn on, it may be a mechanical issue with the sprinkler valve itself. In this case, most standard valves are best to just replace, and it'll cost about $20 to $30. Step three, if the valve operated manually by opening the bleed screw, is to get out a multimeter and check the power at the timer. It should read between 22 and 30 volts. Test this by turning the zone on and then placing the positive probe on the corresponding screw. For me, it was zone 3. I test the other zones as well just to know I tested correctly and I got a solid reading. If that zone does not show proper voltage, it may have a bad timer and need to be replaced. Step 4 is testing the volt reading at the valve itself. The steps are the same as at the timer, but this time, if a zone doesn't show proper voltage, it may be a wire with a bad connection at the wire nut or somewhere in the line. First, test for a proper connection at the wire nut. If that doesn't work, replace the wire. This happened to be my valve's issue, and you can run an individual wire from the timer to the valve. Just make sure to tape and properly water seal the connection. Lastly, after testing the power at the timer and the valve, step 5 is to test the ohm reading at the solenoid. To do this, disconnect the valve's wires from the power source. Turn your multimeter to the omega sign and connect the probes to the wires. It doesn't matter which wires connect for the ohm reading, but it should be between 30 to 50 ohms. If you have a reading of more or less than that, that means you have a bad solenoid and it needs to be replaced. But if everything on this list checks out and you're still having a problem with that valve opening, you're back to having a mechanical issue with that valve and it's best to be replaced. I know that seems like a lot of steps, but if you're relatively handy with a multimeter, it'll only take a couple of minutes to run through everything, and it'll make sure you're not replacing unnecessary parts. I hope that this video was helpful. If it was, please like and subscribe.